Yeah, we have two non-polar liquids, benzene and toluene. They are mixed and the task is divided in A and B. A, do you expect delta H solution to be a large positive number, a large negative number, or close to zero? Explain. I expect delta H solution is close to zero. First of all, there is the question, what is delta H solution? So H is the enthalpy, which provides information about the energy of a thermodynamic system. The enthalpy of a substance cannot be measured, but it's possible to measure the change of the enthalpy, therefore the delta. So delta H is the energy change, and SOL stands for solution. So we have the energy in a solution, the energy change in a solution. How do you get to delta H solution? First, the enthalpy of a solution results from the sum of the energy needed of breaking intermolecular interactions, short II, and inside the benzene and inside the toluene, plus the energy that is set free by forming new intermolecular interactions between benzene and toluene. For breaking IIs, there is energy required. It's an endothermic process. Delta H1 and delta H2 are greater than zero. By forming new IIs, energy becomes free. It's an exothermic process. And delta H3 is smaller or lesser than zero. So delta H solution is defined as delta H1 plus delta H2 plus minus delta H3, because delta H3 is smaller or lesser than zero. Okay. For the visualization, I have two energy diagrams, which shows you the energy of the system. Yeah, the first one, it's an endothermic process. Delta H solution is greater than zero, and the second one is exothermic. Delta H solution is lesser than zero. So there is benzene, C6H6. Yeah, the boiling point is 80.1 degrees Celsius, and we have toluene, C7H8. The boiling point is 111 degrees Celsius. And the molecules look very similar. The IIs are very similar as well. In this case, the IIs are the London forces. The London forces are an attraction between the molecules. We have a short-term electron shift in the electron envelope that leads to a short-term dipole. And this depends on the molecular surface. So similar molecules, and we have similar London forces. So the energy required to break the forces and the energy that is set free by building new forces is nearly the same. Delta H1 plus delta H2 minus delta H3 are around zero. Is delta H solution zero? The solution is ideal. There you can see an energy diagram of an ideal solution. So here we have the second part of the task, B. Benzene and toluene are miscible with each other in all proportions. In making a solution of them, is the entropy of the system increased, decreased, or close to zero compared to the separate pure liquids? The answer is the entropy of the system increases. The entropy is the irreversibility of processes, entropy is the degree of disorder. So, a high degree of disorder is a large entropy, and this is caused by Brownian motion. The entropy of a mixture rises with the degree of miscibility of the components of the mixture. So a good miscibility leads to a large entropy. Yeah. How you could see in A, benzene and toluene are very similar, and similar dissolves in similar. So you can see the separate pure liquids, left and right, and the solution with toluene and benzene. So we have a good miscibility, a large entropy, and a low heat exchange.